In ActivePresenter, each question has a submit button, with the default action to submit all interactions on a slide. If you want your learners to submit all questions at once, instead of repeatedly doing it in each slide, you can create the submit all button in the last question slide. The steps to create the submit all button includes customizing slide master and adding slides in normal view. Let's start with the first part. To open the slide master, in the view tab, click the slide master button. We need to customize the question layout first. In this layout, you add the next and previous buttons to navigate within questions. If clicking the next button, learners will move to the next slide. Therefore, you add the go forward action to the on click event. You copy this button to create the previous button. Similarly, you add the go backward action to the previous button to navigate to the previous slide. After that, you clear the events actions of the answer section to prevent feedback from showing up if a question is answered. We continue editing the report slide layout. The final question links to this layout. Therefore, there will be a submit all button here for learners to submit their answers. I rename this review course button. Then, copy this button to make the submit all button. Tick this option to pause the presentation to wait for user input. When learners click the submit all button, it will hide immediately. Therefore, you drag its time bar shorter. After this button disappears, the review course details show up. So, the start time of these objects has to be equal to the end time of the submit all button. Now you send this button back so that in normal view, you can click the insert report icon. Continue adding events actions to the submit all button. First, add the hide object action to the on click event. You should rename it to add actions more easily. Second, add the continue presentation action, since you paused it before. Third, add an adjust variable action. Before that, you need to add a true false variable with the false default value. Then, you add an adjust variable to change its value to true. After that, you add events actions to the report slide layout. We add the hide object action to the onload event of this layout, to hide the submit all button. Under the condition that, if the review course button, or the submit all button is clicked. This means, after learners submitted their answers and review course, the submit all button no longer shows up again. Return to the question slide layout. We copied these two navigation buttons, then paste them to the review feedback layer, in Feedback Master. Let's switch to Feedback Master view. In the View tab, click the Feedback Master button. Select Review Feedback layer, then paste the buttons here. Here we come to the second part, adding slides in normal view. You can add as many question slides as you want from the Questions tab, and insert a report slide at the end of the course. Next, you modify each question slide by adding question and answer options, setting correct answers. And most importantly, set the attempts option of each question to infinite. Finally, we add the go forward action to the onload event of the first slide, under the condition that the review mode is enabled. This action will help skip the first slide if learners click the review course button. So, that's all about how to create the submit all button in ActivePresenter. Let's preview it now.